There it is again. Our welcome message.
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWEs altered. look at it. 8 inches wide and capable of storing a whopping 80 kilobytes. Stolen by our friends at the CIA, the disk held the launch codes to Soviet nukes. This is not the disk, of course, but one exactly like it. A perfect fusion of concepts vibrating in the Cold War era collective unconscious. A receptacle. It is a receptacle for dangerous energies to hone in on. And they did. We don't have the details, but when things started flying around the disk, it was transferred to us. It's an object of power. OOP. Oops. Oh, and it can launch things telekinetically through the air. To date, we've launched maybe 3 dozen pencils. And once, we even launched a cup.
Communications. We're on the right track. Object of power. It's like the hiss had latched onto it. We need to cleanse it. It's harder to hear you when I'm here. It's like the channel's been changed. The board's in charge here. Their pyramids and bureau seal. Are they really the ones pulling the strings? I'm not their director. I'm no one's director.
Thank you.
There you are. You were gone. Cut off. I got it. Just like you wanted, right? This will help me fight the Hiss. Emily said that the hotline can be reached through the mailroom. There's a key nearby. This must open the door.
You are following. You are annoying us at home. You Listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years. Thank you for staying up with us. Ghosts. We've had many callers over the years tell us of hauntings, voices, and other phantasmagorical phenomena. Today, friend of the show, Dr. Quincy Reagan, tells his story. Quincy.
Thanks. This is something I experienced recently while staying at the Chili Pines Motel in Macon for last year's SuspiciaCon. I was in room 47. The night manager, an avid listener of the program, insisted I take this particular room. Now, the manager explained that years back, the body of a man was discovered under the bed, inside that wooden border that motel beds tend to have. And the body had been there a week, he said. Guests had stayed there, sleeping with the corpse a foot below him. They only found the body when housekeepers complained about the smell. Hauntings have been reported in room 47 ever since. I happily took the room. I fell asleep pretty quick, checking under the bed first, of course. No ghosts visited me, no chilly spots or flickering lights. But when I woke up, I found myself under the bed. It was dark and stiflingly hot. Luckily, I was able to push the mattress off and crawl out before I suffocated. The night manager was kind enough to find me another room.
Oh, there you have it, listeners. What we call ghosts take many forms. Quincy was brave enough to tell his story, and I encourage you to keep calling and writing whenever you encounter something strange, something you can't explain. Maybe you're seeing colors that we have no name for. Maybe your toaster is possessed. Remember, dear listeners, when no one else believes you. You're listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years. Listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years.
Thank you.
Emily said that the hotline can be reached through the mailroom. Great. have a feeling he'll be back. Let's stay focused. The hotline should be past the mailroom.
All right, take this down. The situation in Cuba has been evaluated
Roberto
by
Tomasi, head of comms.
Illness affecting the staff at the U.S. Embassy.
The hiss got him.
Was caused by sonic weaponry in the hands of a foreign power. Numerous personnel have damaged the inner ear, and most are expected to make a full recovery. Of course, the event also damaged their cellular walls, but we can't blame that on some stupid noise gun. Thank God no local doctors examined them first. Honestly, what are the odds of alternate? Show up inside a U.S. embassy. Talk about good luck, huh? So much easier to...
The hotline can't be far now.
The Ocean View Motel and Casino. Dream Logic. The light switch cord.
Right.
been here before? No. I've stayed at a lot of roadside motels across the country, on the road, run, under the radar. This feels like all of them, like something recognized from a dream.
It is a phone. It's an object of power. It doesn't connect to any typical network. A direct line to the astral plane and the board. And my hypothesis is, under the right conditions, to other planes of existence as well.
A director needs a team. My management team. These people know the secrets of the Bureau as well as I do. Some even better. Darling, Tomasi, Salvador, Marshall. Marshall especially, my head of operations. She sees right through me. She knows I don't like relying on people. The only person you should fail is yourself. But things change when you become director.
I have it. The hotline. I can reach Trench. Well, listen to him. He feels more like an echo. An echo with important info. I need to get back to Emily. People react strongly when I tell them about you. Is it too soon to tell Emily? She might be able to help,